Well, they are members of the EIF, they are colleagues, MEP. Welcome to you all to this debate. As you know, the subject of the debate, it is no more no less than the impact of Brexit on data flows. In the context we are living now with this Brexit negotiation with the EU going on, I mean, sometimes with certain speed, more times with not speed at all, the free flow of data and the management of data, it is really at the top of the priority for the digital sector. And when I said the digital sector, I said all sectors, from the economy, from research institutions, from the society in general. So this is something that sooner or later must be at the core of this negotiation in one way or another. It's not only the PAC, it is not only, I mean, of course, we have now to find a way for these main problems of the Czech and the situation of people from EU member states in UK and vice versa. But once this is over, to some extent at least, there's no doubt that the data per se, digital data coming from digital developments and technologies needs to be addressed. And as I said, it is not only the problem of cybersecurity, which is very obvious. It is not only, of course, all the data that has not problems when we are, since we have the same, you know, exchange and the same treatment in terms of imagine in the regarding airplanes travels and these kind of things. I mean, there's a number of data that are circulating. I, of course, this is not affected because it's not affected. You know, it's not a matter of EU or not mostly. But you go sector by sector, I'm not need to go, but just the main areas, imagine the research area is crucial. Research area and big data are absolutely linked in a way that is impossible that research goes on without big data. But not only that, linked to that, medical records. Also in that context, let's say the automobile industry. I mean, this is absolutely essential. Or transport, you want to think in a broader sense. It is, you know, a situation in which this is absolutely crucial. I probably, that will not be the last time we address this. As you know, there is a recent regulation from the Commission dealing with the location of data and eliminating the restrictions that in principle and the fragmentation that in principle we had in Europe, this new regulatory proposal from the Commission goes in that sense to unlock this situation. But regarding specifically the future of UK and EU relationship, I think this is absolutely crucial for you, for the European Union. UK cannot be one more, a third country, in the classical understanding. And of course, for UK, European Union is not and will not never be a third country or third group of countries at all. I mean, this is absolutely clear. I think the will of both parts is like that. Sometimes they will face big obstacles in all aspects of our life, and I am sure that this will find a solution, but the problem is when and how painful can be, at least in the beginning. But to reflect about all this, we have British people here. You know, some of them are serving in this parliament, like is the case of Daniel Dalton, EIF member and MEP of ECR. Are you ECR? No. Yes. Yes. No, I mean, at that moment, I am not sure we left. No, no, you are, of course, is here. well, then we have Joaquin Reiter, Group External Affairs Director, Vodafone. So another one of the same, you know, country. Although Vodafone is let's say, the more multinational in the telecom sector we have in for consumers, a BT also for, you know, for companies, but in the case of consumers, I think it's Vodafone the one that is more present in countries in the European Union beyond UK. And then we have Stephen Harley, which is head of Brexit planning BT Group. And finally, we have Giles Dorrington, head of policy existing at the European Union Tech UK. My colleague Kaili, Eva Kaili, is co-chairing with me this event, but she couldn't stay now. She will be at the end, so she will address some words in the end as well. So thank you very much. Without further ado, please, Daniel, the floor is yours.